So this bucket you see him emptying is actually the drain for our sink. So it was half full when we got to the cabin, and we filled it to the top and didn't know what to do, so we threw it down the urinal. Just a heads up, this is a bit of a running theme in this vlog, so if you're eating food and watching, I apologize. Let's talk toilets. This zebra thing is our toilet. Part of the Antarctic Treaty says that no waste can be dumped in Antarctica. All waste must either be processed or must be taken off the continent. So this is a special type of toilet called a drop toilet. It uses no running water and you're not allowed to do your number ones in there. The reason for this is all the waste drops into a bucket beneath and that waste needs to be processed. If you add water to the solids, it's harder to either process, or it's more expensive to carry off the continent because you're carrying water weighs along with the solids. So this is a number two toilet only.
Whatever you do sinks into the hole.
So what we got?
A half round coin.
70 rand, 170 rand, $4, and then
another 100 rand.
100 rand.
Well, hello and welcome. If you can wipe your feet on the doormat, please come in. Oh, format, we got company. Where's my manners? Let me take your coats. I hope you're hungry for some flavorful quotes, which I whipped on myself. I'm really hoping that you like it. I call it the Godomino special. I either hype it. Format, I think he's still in the kitchen, slaving over platters, you know, cooking rhythms.
So yeah, this massive drum that's been held really precariously on the edge of a forklift's forks while it's going backwards over a massive snowbank is full of urine. So I promise, I didn't intend for this vlog to be so much about waste, but all the footage seemed to line up perfectly to occur on one vlog, so the next ones will be less horrific, I promise.
Dinner served, so yo, come and get it. Abdominal in format, cooking up the splendid concoctions. Explosions of flavor, check the ill culinary behavior. You need seconds? Yo, come and get it. Abdominal in format, whipping up the splendid delicacies.
Teaching champion. Check the ill culinary. Oof.
So we're about to go check out Novo's base, the actual main one. Ooh, sunglasses on. Right, let's get on.
So we're jump shot then?
Jump in the back, something new.
Hi. Novo is sort of like an international hub for Antarctica. It's got a big runway which can take large jets, so a lot of scientists who work in this part of Antarctica fly through Novo. It's made of two parts. There's the runway with all the cabins on the side for people in transit, and then there's the main base where all the Russian science is actually done. Right now we're going to go visit the actual main base, which is about 10 kilometers away from the runway. I hope my little nuance is correct for this distortion, but I say why I say. And who is to say? Cause Roy makes the tune what it is today.
Rhythmically, we in this lake of jeans. Know what I mean? It's only right that me and Mr. Wright, we hail from Queens. The overtone of funk is being driven by the students, the benevolent.
We're at the Novo guest house. I'm not sure what else to say. That's a guest, that's a house. And here's some badass driving.
The other guys are behind us, waiting. Oh, God, I'm gonna get one of these trucks. I've no use for it, but I want one.
Of Russia, wow. And Soviet Union. This is previous photos, previous expeditions. Soviet expedition. This is photo. United expedition. Russian, Soviet. This year, Soviet and Germany.
Uh-huh. Oh, wow.
Soviet expedition. Germany.
I want to say tank that opened up this station. Is that a tank?
It's a sort of personnel carrier.
Personnel carrier, but it looks like a tank and it's awesome. It's definitely a tank.
This one,